Hello, just an unboxing and a quick look at this ball head I got off AliExpress. This is a fairly cheap ball head that I'm gonna use for my YouTube camera. You see ball head here and look at the logo. It kind of resembles Manfrotto just a little bit. But of course, Manbilly. You can see the box kind of got a lot of damage doing shipping. But I hope the product is fine. I haven't opened it yet. I want to open it with you guys. Okay, front side here. Right side. Manbilly, ball head. Kind of got the same branding all over. Just Manbilly ball head. On the top side here, KF0, it's the model number, Manbilly, and the bottom, nothing really. Let's open this up. Have a look inside. Okay, the ball head of course, and I think this is a pricing label. If you're a store, you could put your price here. Manbilly KF/0, and you can see the website down there. I don't know if you can see it, but manbilly.com. Again, this is first time I have a look at it, so I've only seen it in the images on the website on AliExpress. I thought it looked like it was good quality, but only time will tell, I guess. This one, see the little screw, from the bigger to the small size. I can't remember what it's called. Is it 1/4 the small and 3/8 the big screw, I think. And of course the ball head here, the faceplate on top. The reason why I got this is because my camera, which is the Panasonic FC300 or 330 as it's called in UK, the screw hole for the head, it's not centered, it's off to the right, so there's not a lot of room between the thread below the camera and the battery door, which also is located at the bottom. So I hope this one with the screw set here, I hope I can open the battery door without having to take the whole camera off the head every time. So that was the main reason I chose this. Also, it got three knobs, so one should be controlling the pan mode here, pan movement. As you can see here, it's moving around the little knob here, and now it's all steady. The second one should be controlling the ball head retention, you know, how quickly it will, or easily it will move around. I can tighten it here, and it'll be harder for me, you know, can see, to turn it around and move the ball head. And of course the big button here, it just locks the ball head in place. I like this setup, so I can control the resistance on the ball head for, you know, the size and the weight of the camera. So I can move it without it falling over. At the same time, a separate locking button, a locking, tighten up here for locking it in place. And you can do panorama shots here. Oh, it's actually nice and smooth. Let's have a look at the bottom. I believe this is a 3/8 inch screw. It's the big size screw here. So yeah, This is pretty, I think, standard for mounting heads to a tripod. I'm using the Manfrotto right now. I have plans to buy a more sturdy Manfrotto. I have a 4-section now. I would like only 3-section, so the legs would be a little more sturdy. Anyways, yeah, let's try to take off the faceplate. There we go. And you can see it has a little thingy to hold it, so you can tighten it to the camera. Plus it also has a standard screwdriver ridge here, so you can tighten it with just a key or a coin or anything. It's just standard quick release plate, and it shouldn't be able to, you know, fall off just by moving it back and forward. So you can see I can move it to either side and it shouldn't fall off unless I tighten this all the way, and it won't come off then. So yeah, I must say, nice quality for the money I paid for it. It's pretty inexpensive. And it seems to be a quality that's, you know, when you buy from China, often you get a good quality for a very low price. Manbili KF/0. I think it's a great head, cheap head. And it should be great for video and photo shooting. You also got a little level, so you can see if it's completely centered or not, or level. Oh, also one here in the screw for the faceplate. So yeah, we get the head, some price sticker without the price. I guess the stores will use this one. And this little converter, so you can convert it to a standard a 1/4 inch, I believe it's called, from a 3/3 inch. Thank you for watching. I hope you find it useful. Take care. Bye bye.